Ar-Rahman, Ar-Rahim. السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. الحمد لله والصلاة والسلام على رسول الله وعلى آله وصحبه ومن والاه. عالم الغيب والشهادة العزيز الحكيم. ذلك عالم الغيب والشهادة العزيز الرحيم. In many verses you find that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala saying that he is the owner of علم الغيب and شهادة, the witness bearer at the same time. On another place, you find that Allah says that the one who has the knowledge of the unseen and the one who is the witness bearer. What does he mean by this? This is to tell us, he is the one who knows what happens of the unseen, things that me and you cannot comprehend, things that me and you do not have access to. When the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wasallam went to Isra and Mi'raj, that was knowledge that Allah provided him with, which he would not provide anyone else. What do we understand from this? Al-ghayb ghayban. There are two types of unseen things, or two types of unseen knowledges. The first type is al-ghayb al-mutlaq, the knowledge of the unseen which is encompassing everything. That belongs to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. What do I mean by this? It's the type of knowledge which says, مَتَ السَّاعَةِ, when is Qiyamah? It's the type of knowledge which tells us what's going to happen next, perhaps. But there is another ghayb which is known as al-ghaybun nisbi. It is known as the knowledge of the unseen which can be relatable to others like the prophets. That's why Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, عَالِمُ الْغَيْبِ فَلَا يُظْهِرُ عَلَىٰ غَيْبِهِ أَحَدًا. The one who has the knowledge of the unseen and he does not manifest it to anyone whomsoever he doesn't want, except إِلَّا مَنِ ارْتَضَى مِنْ رَسُولٍ, except for the one that he is satisfied by as a prophet to give him the knowledge. What do we find by this? We understand that the reason why Allah favored the prophets with the knowledge of the unseen on certain areas, things that they can comprehend as human beings also, is to provide them with miracles at least so that they can be proved as prophets on this earth. Does he open it for anyone else? لا. Also, this is what should happen to me and you. As a benefit of knowing that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is the one who bears the knowledge of the unseen, and he is the one who is going to bear witness of everything that happens on this earth from our deeds and everything that happens on the atmosphere, which we do not have any access to, is that we have to understand, if some things, they're not in our hands, they belong to Allah. If we see that something is not happening, we do not question why isn't Allah bringing things onto my favor. We don't have the knowledge of what's happening on the other side. We don't know what's going to happen next. The next benefit that we take is that we should be calm in the sense that if we do not have knowledge of what's outside there, which doesn't belong to us, it is not our problem to bother ourselves. If we ask today, how does Jibreel alayhi salam look like? The only way we can find his description is through Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wasallam and how he defined him to us. If it wasn't for the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wasallam, we wouldn't have even comprehended how Jibreel himself looks like, which means Allah put a veil in between us on things that we are not allowed to see, lest that we might even lose our minds. I just want you to ask yourself a very simple question. Why do you think Allah put this globe, this world, in the middle of nowhere, where if you look above you, it doesn't have any string, below you there's no string, and on your right and left there is no string, and there is no ending, it's total darkness, and there is a limit on gravity where it goes? The question is, if Allah opened up the doors for us to see those things, would we have been able to handle them? Would our minds even take them in? Would we be able to even understand what's going on? That is why we have to thank Allah for being able to put a veil between us and let Him be the only one, the possessor of the knowledge that we cannot have access to. Bye.